pale blue dot is a famous photograph of planet Earth taken on February 14, 1990, by the Voyager 1 space probe from a record distance of about 6 billion kilometers. In the photograph, Earth's apparent size is less than a pixel. The planet appears as a tiny dot against the vastness of space, among bands of sunlight reflected by the camera. Earth is the only world known so far to harbor life. Are we alone? One of the many intriguing mysteries is whether or not there is life out there. Ever since Galileo first looked through his telescope and spotted moons on Jupiter, astronomers have been wondering what they might find if they could look further into the night sky as we progress in our understanding of the universe. The observable universe is a ball-shaped region of the universe comprising all matter that can be observed from Earth or from space-based telescopes at the present time. The electromagnetic radiation from these objects has reached Earth since the beginning of the Big Bang. Galaxies are vast collections of stars that populate our universe. While different experts vary, an acceptable range is between 100 and 200 billion galaxies in the observable universe. The big question: where is everybody? Many experts since have grappled with the same question. Why, considering the multitude of planets and stars in the Milky Way, have we not heard from anyone? We call this problem the Fermi paradox. Are humans unique and alone in the vast universe? In 1961, astrophysicist Frank Drake developed the Drake equation to gauge the number of advanced civilizations likely to exist in the Milky Way galaxy. The Milky Way is home to 200 to 400 billion stars. Crunching the Drake equation with various values, the number n is equal to the advanced civilizations in the Milky Way. The result from the Drake equation ranges from as low as zero, which means we are probably alone, to as high as 15,600,000, which means the Milky Way is home to millions of distinct intelligent civilizations. SETI is another research organization solely devoted to searching for and studying life and intelligence beyond Earth. Researchers here conducted experiments to look for proof not merely of life elsewhere, but of intelligent beings. So far, scientists have not found convincing evidence beyond our home planet. Many people are convinced that after six decades of searching, the fact that SETI researchers have yet to pick up a signal from space is perhaps the most compelling evidence that Earth is really the only place where life exists. Although there are more reasonable explanations for the fact that SETI antenna receivers have so far heard nothing that's clearly extraterrestrial, the experiments have simply not examined enough of the sky, or perhaps the antennas don't have enough sensitivity, or maybe they've not been dialed to the correct frequency. Nonetheless, scientists are confident that it's just a matter of time until we discover convincing proof that intelligence exists elsewhere. I hope we are lucky enough to find and confirm an alien signal in our lifetime. NASA's latest powerful James Webb Space Telescope captured a direct image of an exoplanet outside of our solar system named HIP-65426b. The exoplanet in Webb's image is a gas giant, which means it could not support life. This is revolutionary and exciting. JWST is a very powerful telescope, although it's not designed to search for alien life. It has onboard technologies that can detect a planet's atmosphere. What is an exoplanet? An exoplanet is any planet beyond our solar system. So far, scientists have categorized it into the following types: gas giant, Neptunian, super-Earth, and terrestrial. How do we know what's in the atmosphere of an exoplanet? During a transit, some of the star's light travels through the planet's atmosphere and gets absorbed. The light that survives carries information about the planet across light years of space, where it reaches our telescopes. However, the planet is very small relative to the star, so it's very difficult to detect, which is why we need a big telescope like Webb to be sure to capture this tiny bit of light. So how do we use a telescope to read transit light? Stars emit light at many wavelengths, like a prism makes a rainbow. We can separate light into its separate wavelengths. This is called a spectrum visible. Light appears to our eyes as the colors of the rainbow, but beyond visible light, there are many wavelengths we cannot see. Now back to the transiting planet. As light is traveling through the planet's atmosphere, some wavelengths get absorbed. Which wavelengths get absorbed depends on which molecules are in the planet's atmosphere. For example, carbon monoxide molecules will capture different wavelengths than water vapor molecules. So when we look at that planet in front of the star, some of the wavelengths of the starlight will be missing depending on which molecules are in the atmosphere of the planet. Learning about the atmospheres of other worlds is how we identify those that could potentially support life, bringing us another step closer to answering one of humanity's oldest questions. Are we alone? How many exoplanets have been detected so far? To date, more than 5,000 exoplanets have been discovered and are considered confirmed out of the billions in our galaxy alone. There are thousands of other candidate exoplanet detections that require further observations in order to say for sure whether or not the exoplanet is real. Remarkably, the first exoplanets were just discovered in the 1990s. We live in an extraordinary time where, in the span of a single generation, the centuries-old question, are there planets orbiting other stars, has been answered with a resounding yes. While some people believe that the aliens with their advanced technology have already visited us, this is not a popular idea among most scientists. We need solid evidence of an alien life outside of our planet. Our search so far haven't detected anything yet. But as humans, we're curious and always searching for an answer. We now have developed new and modern technologies that can hopefully help us answer this question. Are we alone? The late British science fiction author Sir Arthur C. Clarke, who said, "Two possibilities exist. Either we are alone in the universe, or we are not. Both are equally terrifying." Thanks for watching. Did you like this video? Then show your support by liking, subscribing, and ringing the bell to never miss videos like this.